Hello, this is your daily dose of news from On Manorama. I'm your host Manna Mena Cheri, and these are the major news stories of Tuesday, January 23, 2024. In Assam, Bharat Jodo Nai Yatra was stopped from entering the capital city. Chief Minister Himanta Biswa Sarma instructed police to register a case against Rahul Gandhi for provoking the crowd after Congress workers broke barricades and raised slogans. The row over the screening of Ram Ki Naam documentary at K.R. Narayanan Institute has prompted CPM's youth wing DYFI to announce that it would show the documentary across Kerala. Tamil Nadu Governor R.N. Revy courted controversy after he said Mahatma Gandhi's protests after 1942 were ineffective in giving the country independence. A man suspected of shooting 8 people in Chicago was found dead in Texas. 2 among 3 Pakistani natives were arrested for abducting, murdering and burying the body of a Keralite in Dubai. The third accused is absconding, the police said. Let's get into the details. The Rahul Gandhi-led Bharat Jodo Nai Yatra was stopped from entering Guwahati city, triggering protests from Congress workers who broke barricades and raised slogans. The police had to use force to stop the Congress supporters from moving forward. Chief Minister Himanta Biswa Sarma had said earlier that the Yatra would not be allowed to enter the city in order to avoid traffic jams. Sarma instructed the Director General of Police to register a case against Gandhi for provoking the crowd to break barricades and called their actions Naxalite tactics. He said the Congress leader's unruly behavior and violation of the agreed guidelines resulted in a massive traffic jams in Guwahati. In his reply, Gandhi lashed out at the Assam Chief Minister, saying that such actions would only benefit the Yatra as it would get more publicity. He said the Nai Yatra has become the main issue in Assam. DYFI Central Secretariat member Jake C. Thomas said that the left-wing youth organization will arrange a screening of documentary Ram Ki Naam on Tuesday at K.R. Narayanan Institute. His comments come a day after when the students of K.R. Narayanan National Institute of Visual Science and Arts screened the documentary Ram Ki Naam. 13 people from the locality staged a protest outside the campus at Kanjiramattam, Kottayam in central Kerala. Later, the screening was held inside the campus while members of the right-wing Hindu groups protested outside the closed gates. Ram Ki Naam, directed by Anand Padwardhan, focuses on BJP leader L.K. Advani's Rath Yatra that led to the demolition of Ayodhya's Babri Masjid on December 6, 1992. Kar Sevaks of Vishwa Hindu Parishad and allied Hindu organizations participated in the demolition. Meanwhile, Malayalam actor Mohanlal became a target of online abuse after he did not attend the consecration of Ram's idol at Ayodhya temple. Tamil Nadu Governor R.N. Revy has once again invited controversy for slighting the contributions of Mahatma Gandhi to the Indian independence movement. Revy said, and I quote, "Mahatma Gandhi's struggle after 1942 did not bear fruit. Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose won independence for the country through strong resistance. Netaji's sacrifice should be remembered and appreciated like any other." He added that Muhammad Ali Jinnah introduced the sectarianism in the country. The governor made his remarks at a program held on the Anna University campus in connection with the birth anniversary of Subhash Chandra Bose. Meanwhile, allegations have also been raised that the university authorities forced the students to participate in the program and denied the attendance to those who did not participate. A man suspected of shooting 8 people to death and wounding another in suburban Chicago has turned up dead hundreds of miles away in Texas. He seems to have taken his own life after an encounter with law enforcement there, police said on Monday. The death of 23-year-old Romeo Nance near the town of Natalia, Texas, ended a manhunt that began with the slaying of one man and wounding of another in 2. Chicago area shooting on Sunday, police said. The search for the suspect in Sunday's gun violence led police to discover of two more crime scenes on Monday in the city of Joliet, Illinois, where seven members of one family were found shot to death in two houses across the street from each other. A case has been filed against three Pakistani natives for abducting, murdering, and burying the body of a Keralite in Dubai. The police have arrested two of the accused. The third accused is absconding. The body of Anil Vincent, who went missing on January 2, was recovered by authorities on January 12. According to the police, Anil was murdered at a godown and then buried in the desert. The accused include his colleagues. Anil, a public relations officer at a trading company in Dubai, went missing after he accompanied one of the men for stock inspection. He had gone for stock taking on the direction of his brother Prakash, who works in the same company. The accused were arrested following the investigation based on the family's complaint. A Pakistan native, the driver of the vehicle used for hiding the body, escaped to Pakistan. According to the police, Anil was killed by the accused over some personal enmity. Anil's mortal remains were cremated in Kerala. That brings us to the end of this episode. Thanks for listening to Daily News Dose, hosted by me, Manna Mena Cheri. Daily News Dose is produced by Vishnu Muralidharan with technical support from Idea Brew Studios. Follow www.onmanorama.com for detailed updates on latest news, and be sure to come back tomorrow.